Kingdom Come is not your usual RPG. It tries to be true to historical life, which means no dragons and occasional bouts of the plague. It can also be rock hard, with lots of the game's most useful features hidden away for you to find and unpick. This video will help you take the edge off some of those challenges, whether it's helping you level up lockpicking with ease or becoming an archery master. Here are our killer tips and tricks to get ahead in Kingdom Come Deliverance. One of Kingdom Come's more unusual mechanics is using alcohol to save the game. It'll automatically save at key story moments and when you sleep in your bed, but if you want to save manually, you need savior snaps. They are expensive to buy, so it's better to make your own. Here's how. You'll need an alchemy bench. The first obvious one you'll find in the game is in the city of Ratte. Once you've woken up in the mill, you can head to the town square and find it behind the local apothecary. For starters, you need nettles and belladonna. They can be picked in the wild, but traders near alchemy benches sell them too. Look at the recipe book on the right and you can hold A to automatically bring out ingredients you need to cook with. Return to the alchemy set by pressing B and select the wine on the left shelf and add it to the cauldron. Now you want to add one handful of nettles to the cauldron. Bring it to the boil by tapping the left trigger to use the bellows. It'll bubble when it's boiling. You need to boil it for 2 turns measured by the hourglass. You press the right trigger to turn the hourglass. Squeeze the bellows while the sand is running to keep it boiling before turning the hourglass a second time. Next, you need to grind 2 handfuls of belladonna in the pestle and mortar. Once you've added 2 handfuls to the mortar, press A to grind it up. Then press A on the cauldron to tip the contents into the cauldron. Use the bellows to bring it to the boil. You only need to do this for 1 turn of the hourglass. Once the sand has finished flowing, you can pick up a vial from the bottom left shelf and use it on the mixture to get your savior schnapps. It feels very fiddly, but it's really worth putting in the time and brewing up some schnapps. It's good to manually save the game before entering combat or picking a lock. A lot can go wrong in Kingdom Come. Lockpicking is one of the most important skills in the game. Several quests are hard to resolve without robbing people blind, but it is also one of the harder skills to crack, or at least it seems that way. The key to mastering lockpicking is to play through the story missions until you reach the city of Ratte, a couple of hours into the game. You wake up in a mill, and if you talk to the miller, you can ask for lockpicking lessons. He not only gives you a few lockpicks to keep, but explains the technique slightly better than the in-game tutorial text. It's quite simple, really. You use the right analog stick to guide the circle towards the sweet spot. It turns gold when you hit it. Once it's turned gold, you can use the left stick to rotate the lock. The tricky bit is that the sweet spot moves with the lock, so you have to turn the 2 sticks in unison. My key tip for this is to turn off the controller rumble. It's much harder to track the sweet spot with the stick vibrating. I also like to push the left analog stick as far as it will go so that you're sliding it along the plastic of the controller base. This makes it easier to rotate in one slick move. Finally, use a savior schnapps before attempting any locks so that you can quick load if you run out of picks. Master these basics and there's a killer exploit you can use. Yes, if you crack the miller's training lock, then you can cheese your way to a higher level. The miller lets you practice on this empty box whenever you want, and every time you unlock it, you get XP towards the lockpick skill. You just need to open and close the lid of the box to lock it again. Spend 10 to 15 minutes unlocking it and you'll see your lockpick skill shoot up, earning you some brilliant perks early in the game. Once you reach lockpicking skill 3, you want to buy the lasting lockpicks perk. This gives you much more room for error, as the lockpicks won't break as easily. It also means it's even easier to keep boosting on the miller's lockbox. Next up, you want to push to level 6 and unlock the Deft Grip perk, as this shortens the distance you have to rotate the lock. Again, training speeds up as a result. If you want to go the whole hog, keep cheesing the lock until you reach level 12 and you can unlock the Master Thief perk. This ability lets you automatically unlock easier locks, which means you don't even have to play the mini game as you exploit the miller's magic box. With this one unlocked, you just have to tap A to open the box and get your XP. Pile in an hour of unlocking and you'll be able to tackle the hardest lock really early in the game. Think of it as revenge on the designers for including such a tricky lockpick game. Another tricky skill in Kingdom Come is archery. To begin with, it can feel like only 1 in 10 shots are actually landing. As with everything in the game, the more archery you do, the steadier your shot becomes. But there's a great way to clean up your act early on. You see, when you draw your bow, you lose the aiming reticule on screen. Our solution? Put away your bow to reveal the reticule and stick a tiny piece of blue tack over the cursor. This way, when the bow comes back out, you've still got a guide of what you're aiming at. The key now is to compensate for the arrow drop. As a rule, you always want to aim a little higher than the target. You also have to contend with the natural sway of your arm. I like to aim the cursor over the head of my target, draw back the string, and then wait for the natural side-to-side sway to line me up over the target before releasing the right trigger. Okay, so it means sticking some grotty gunk on your lovely TV screen, but if it means sniping rabbits with ease, it's a price I'm willing to pay. Our hero, Henry, is a peasant, so is unable to read. Annoyingly, there are loads of books which boost his skills, so it's worth educating yourself as soon as you can. Once you've arrived in Ratte, you want to find the city scribe. He'll tell you about a teacher in a city called Erhitz who will help you master the reading. Handily, this chat unlocks a side mission called Mightier Than the Sword, which adds the teacher to the map. The city is quite far away, so it's worth pushing through a couple of story missions until you're given your own horse. You can then gallop up to Erhitz for a lesson. Once you can read, you'll need skill books to boost both the reading skill and whatever skill the book covers. Handily, the scribe in Erhitz sells two reading skill books. The best place to read is sitting on a bed, either one you've got regular access to, like the mill in Ratte, or one you've paid for at a tavern. When you sit down, you'll see a blue book icon, indicating that your concentration will be boosted whilst reading. This way, you can get through books much faster and level up those skills in no time. The next tip defies the law of physics, but is cheeky enough to get away with it. One of the biggest threats to thieves in Kingdom Come are the random searches that local guards will perform. If they catch you with stolen goods, they'll take them away. Rather than run the risk of discovery, whenever I steal something, I go into the inventory, find the offending item, and use the X button to send it to my horse. Your horse doesn't have to be close to receive stolen goods. That's the physics breaking bit. And the guards never think of searching the saddlebags. Who knew that this humble horsey is actually a criminal conspirator? Even better, stolen goods are forgotten about after a period of time, so you can just leave them in the saddlebags until the red hand symbol that denotes stolen goods vanishes. Now feel free to sell your hard-swiped spoils. Of course, once you've used your horse to launder stolen goods, it's time to sell them. One very easy way to make more money is to avoid selling your items in a big batch, as it limits your opportunity to make more money from haggling. If you sell 5 items in one bundle, you'll be able to make a few extra coins on the transaction, but it's far more beneficial to haggle for each item individually. The downside is that it draws out the game. There's a lot of menus to get through before haggling, but it's a good way of saving up extra money in the early stages of the game where every penny counts. As Henry levels up skills, he can unlock perks that further modify those abilities. There's a case to be made for most perks, but I wanted to pick out the most useful we've encountered. Under Henry's main level, we banked our perk points and waited until we were level 6 in order to unlock Burger and First Aid 2. Burger adds 1 point to your strength, agility, vitality, and speech when in urban areas. Considering this is where you're going to find most of the population and traders, that speech boost helps a lot, while strength and agility kicks in when trouble kicks off with local guards. And First Aid 2 unlocks some useful conversation options and saves on bandage usage, both good in the long run. In the speech category, I saved a perk point for Empathetic. It's unlocked slightly later at level 8, but the ability to see your rival's speech stats is really useful for deciding what angle to take with them. I also like Silver Tongue, which punches up your speech stat during haggling, key to squeezing every last penny out of those medieval suckers. As for vitality perks, I'm a big fan of Balanced Diet, which gives you a +1 vitality and agility bonus when you've gone 5 days without feeling starved or overfed. As long as you keep your inventory stocked with food and use cooking pots whenever you find them, it's easy to manage nourishment levels and benefit from that stat boost. I also unlocked the Mule 1 perk under the Strength category because I can never get enough of a larger inventory allowance. Even with your horse to help share the load, there's always more loot than one man can carry. Finally, I bought Stronghold, which lightens the stamina cost of blocking in combat. There are more interesting fighting perks to be had in the individual weapon categories, but anything that slows stamina loss in fights gets a big gauntlet thumbs up from me. So those are a few tips to help you survive the harsh world of Kingdom Come Deliverance. It's a huge game with loads of systems to master, but I hope these point you in the right direction. At the very least, you'll be lockpicking with ease. If you've got any tips to share, make sure to include them in the comments below. We love to hear your advice. If you found this video useful, please do subscribe to the channel, drop a like on the video, and we'll see you again soon. Bye!